This is a sneak peek from a 5-part mixing and mastering series taught by Reid, Stefan, the realest puppet in the game. The full series is available exclusively to iZotope subscribers, along with the latest product updates, professionally crafted presets, samples, and much, much more.
Hello, and welcome back to iZotope Producers Club. My name is Reid Stefan, realest puppet in the game, and this is Mixing and Mastering with Neutron and Ozone. In this course, we're going to be mixing and mastering the Ableton session for a track I produced for Easy McCoy called My Time. And not only am I going to be walking you through all the plugin presets and processes that I do on the drums, bass, synths, vocals, and master channel, but I'm also going to give you a little bit insight into the mentality and philosophy behind why I make certain decisions. Now, in every track, there comes a time when you're done making individual adjustments and it's time to group everything up and kind of consolidate all the different layers of your track into maybe 5 main layers. In most instances, I like to do bass, drums, synths, vocals, and master chain. Now, when you're producing, obviously you're making mixing decisions and doing sound design and molding and constructing the way that your song should sound. So you do have some mixing done, but there comes a point when you want to stop and group everything up and start focusing on what you could do to glue all the sounds within the group together and then glue all those groups together with your master chain. And that's the big difference between production and mixing. Because when I'm producing, I'm focusing in on one sound, usually soloing channels. And when I'm mixing, I'm usually focused on groups of sounds. And I only solo groups, if at all, usually no soloing, which is what I do when I'm mixing. And especially when I'm mastering, there's really no point in soloing any individual channel at all. So there's a very big difference between how I think and what I'm focusing on when I'm mixing and mastering. In addition to that, the time that you spend producing is most likely extensive. And not only is it helpful due to ear fatigue to give yourself a break, but it's also helpful to go and listen to other things to sort of mentally cleanse your palate and come back with fresh ears, a new day, to start making some final decisions. Because after you've been trying this versus that and A-B-ing different things, maybe scrolling through presets, whatever it took to put your song together, there's certainly been so much information that has gone through your head, and it's so much better when you're making your final decision to start with a fresh palette. Because after all, that's what your listeners are going to do. They're starting with a fresh palette. And as a mixing and mastering engineer, I highly recommend you should too. The point of this course is to leave you with the skills, knowledge, and understanding to mix and master your own songs by yourself, because most of the time you don't have a separate engineer to do so. So my number one tip for mixing and mastering your own songs is always leave yourself at least an overnight sleep between finishing your production, finishing your mix, and going in and doing the final master. So now that we understand the different phases of production, mixing, and mastering, let's dive a little bit into what we can do to actually begin our mix. Here in the Ableton session, as you could see, we have about 40 channels, and that includes all the vocals, all the drums, and everything. The production on this song is completely finished, and it's time for it to be mixed. So the first thing that I want to do is organize my song into all the different mix groups that I'm going to be using. The first group that I like to have is my sub. So that's up here at the top with my disrespectful 808. We could skip down to the next channel, and this is where we have all of our drums. And now to organize these a little bit better for mixing, I'd like to have what's called a drums group, drum sum, drums bus, all different names for the same thing. And that's going to go all the way down till tambourine loop. Okay, so this looks like these are all of our drums. So in Ableton, you just hold shift, click, and then hit command G. And now that created us our own mix group. Command R, and we'll type in drums. And let's give this a color. I like to make my drums purple. So now we have great color for our drums, and this is going down to our master exactly where we want it to. The next group I want to do is going to be all my synths and effects. I don't really feel the need to completely separate them. They're all trying to achieve the same thing. So let's just highlight all these tracks and put them all into a group and call this instruments. And let's give this its own color too, and give this more of an orange color. And now we're down into our vocals, and we have all the male vocals from Easy McCoy. And we can actually just highlight this group. And let's hit Command G, because we're going to put Kara's female vocals during the bridge. and Easy's all in one group, and we can call this vocals. So now we have our mix a little bit more easy to look at, a little bit more easy to understand. And when you're focusing on mixing, again, you're really worried about how these individual stems sound. Even though we haven't actually printed stems, you really don't need to. If you have a fast enough computer to group everything up and add more plugins to the group, I'd say go ahead and just skip the whole step of stems altogether. It's really just for simplicity's sake, for sending to somebody, or if your computer's not fast enough to handle it. But for everybody else, I would follow along and just say group all your channels and let's put some plugins on your groups. That way you don't have to commit to anything in the future. If you want to go back and change something, you can, but I know that this production is finished, so this is exactly how I would do it all in one session. And another useful tip to those of you who aren't using Ableton, where I'm using groups, you can use send and return channels, or buses as they call them in other DAWs. So where I'm using these groups, you can always use whatever method your DAW has. So now we have all of our groups named and colored. We can even right click and assign the color to the whole entire thing. To make it even more organized, I'm actually going to keep the vocals separate colors, but I really like what it does to the drums and the instruments. And let's take a listen to what our production sounds like as a rough mix.
Now I can get it jumping when it's crunch time. Yeah, I'm all about it on the front line. I put that work in, yeah, I done time. I'm 24/7, never sometime. I'm looking like the light, like the sunshine. I got my city looking good like the summertime. And I ball all year, not just summertime. If you see her riding with me, bet she's summer fine. Yeah, she one of mine. This is my time. Yeah. Uh-huh. I'm going back to back.
And as you can see, this mix is so far in the red, that doesn't leave us any room to put any processing on the master channel at all. So the first thing I like to do before I mix is take all my production and reduce the volume to a level where it's just clipping sometimes. I don't need to completely avoid clipping altogether, but just as a general rule of thumb, I always like to pull down my production groups about -6 to create about 6 decibels of headroom before any mixing and mastering.
Yeah. Now I can get it jumping when it's crunch time. Yeah, I'm all about it on the front line. I put that work in, yeah, I done time. I'm 24/7, never sometime. I'm looking like the light, like the sunshine. I got my city looking good like the summertime. And I ball all year, not just summertime. If you see her riding with me, bet she's summer fine. Yeah, she one of mine. This is my time. Yeah. I'm going back to back, making double mine.
So as you can see, we have a little bit of clipping during the loudest part, but during the intro, well below clipping, which is a great rule of thumb. You definitely don't want your intro to be full volume. You want the chorus or the drop, depending on what style of your music you're making, to be hitting the loudest on your master. Let's take one more listen to the loudest part of the song and see if there's any slight volume adjustments I want to make to these groups before we put on our temporary master chain.
Back making double mine. Double up twice, yeah, double time. I put it on the line when I go for mine. Ain't no stopping me, yeah, it's go time. I go hard in the paint when it's showtime.
As I'm pulling down the vocal, I'm always listening for the point where the lyrics are just slightly louder than the whole entire beat. Obviously, this is a very vocal-driven record, so you want the vocals to be the loudest thing. First, I thought they were slightly too loud, so I just went and pulled them down -2 dB, which gives us a little bit more headroom here on the master to play with, which is very handy, and I felt like just made the beat feel even louder and more disrespectful. Sometimes you have to turn down the vocals to make the beat feel louder, and that's exactly what I just did here. Now that we've got all of our groups leveled and properly gain staged with some headroom to play with here on the master channel, let's go ahead and put a copy of Ozone 9, and this is what's going to hold our temporary master chain while we do all of our mixing. I always prefer to have a limiter in place, giving me the effect of what a master chain would do, and the Ozone 9 maximizer is perfect for that. My favorite limiting mode is an IRC4. I really love the modern one.
This is my time. Give me my shine. This is my time.
And we can close this because we're not going to need this for now, because all this is doing, like I said, is acting as our temporary master chain to give us the effect of what the song is going to sound like with the final volume clipped right at 0 dB as we would deliver it to a record label or a DSP like Spotify or YouTube. So there you have it, how I like to finish my production and start my mix by consolidating my tracks, grouping them, coloring them, gain staging, balancing, and adding a temporary master chain to get you started and ready to mix. In the next lesson, we're going to be diving into the drums and bass of My Time by Easy McCoy and adding transients, excitement, and EQ to make them more punchy and sit better in the mix.